exclusive. They're all here, live for the first time since America's new idol was crowned. The winner is David Cook. David and the nine finalists take you behind the scenes and let you in on what they were thinking and what they were feeling on the most incredible night of their lives. Find out what you didn't see and hear in the American Idol finale. They're taking your calls, too, next. And only on Larry King Live. We begin with the seventh winner of American Idol's series, David Cook. And we'll be joined later by the runner-up, David Archuleta, and then the two of them will be together, and then the whole cast. And on Monday night, the whole cast for the whole show, the whole cast being the winner and the nine finalists. David, congratulations.
Thank you, Larry.
Nice having you with us. Were you a little concerned that apparently, again, this is a media feeling, that the younger David was favored all week?
You know, honestly, I didn't pay too much attention all week. I was just kind of trying to focus in on having a good time because it's such a crazy moment, you know, to be on the finale of American Idol. And to share it with somebody as cool as Archie, I was just trying to enjoy it. And so when they called my name, I've watched it back a couple times now, and I think I was genuinely shocked, you know. I thought Archie did an amazing job on Tuesday and had pretty much resigned myself to second, so.
You did?
Yeah.
So some winners have honestly sometimes admitted to me, I thought I was going to win.
I honestly didn't. I went into this with no expectations, and I didn't want to at any point have any. So, but based off what the judges said on Tuesday, I certainly thought I was taking silver.
Let's take another look at that winning moment, which David Cook and his mother will never forget. Let's watch.
Here we go, America. Ladies and gentlemen, David and David. The winner, by 12 million votes, of American Idol 2008 is David Cook.
What's it like to see it again?
It's a bit of a different experience, to be honest. I never in my wildest dreams could have imagined that this was going to be how it went for me. I figured when I hit 24 that I was going to stay a week. But that's the great thing about this show is it's very unexpected, and here I am.
Tell me how you came to enter.
I was standing in line in Omaha, Nebraska with my little brother Andrew. He had wanted to audition for years, and finally got the courage to do it. Asked me if I'd come as moral support. So I went with no intention of auditioning, and then we're standing in line. It's 5:30 in the morning, and the producer comes up with a camera, interviews my brother, turns to me, and I'm like, "Whoa, I'm not auditioning." And he goes, "Well, you are now." Life has a crazy way of working itself out sometimes. Yeah.
Well, how does Andrew feel about all this?
When we walked out of the arena after the first round of auditions, Andrew and I actually auditioned together, and I made it, and he didn't. And I asked him, you know, if he wanted me to do this, because if he didn't, I wouldn't. And he said if he didn't, he would kick my expletive. And so he's been amazing, you know, to have his support from the get made the whole thing for me.
How's he feel now? Happy?
He feels like now hopefully he can enjoy some of the fruits of my labor. So
your other brother is ill, right?
Yes.
It's brain cancer he has?
Yeah, my brother's had a brain tumor now for about a decade, yeah.
10 years?
Yeah. It's amazing.
You know? How's he doing?
He's fighting, you know, and I tried to really keep it out of the public when I was on the show just because, win or lose, I wanted to make sure, and he wanted the same thing, for me to have success or failure based on my own merit. And, so it's exciting now to kind of be out in the open and be able to kind of make, hopefully, you know, help shed some light on this. It's obviously a terrible thing. And,
but he's 10 years is significant.
Yeah. He's been, you know, that he's my American Idol, to kind of use a cheesy paraphrase. He's to be able to watch him these last 10 years kind of fight this head on. You know,
and now
amazing.
With the Ted Kennedy story, mm-hmm. more national focus on it.
Yeah, and you know, hopefully all these things, all these terrible, terrible things that are going on, with people being diagnosed, I can only hope that it leads to a cure. You know?
How's the family, though, dealing with it? Here we've got the highest moment you could have in your life and still a sadness at home.
You know, for me, I welcomed it in a very strange way. You know, to be able to walk on stage... knowing that there are things that are way more important to me than whether or not I win this title, you know, probably gave me a little bit better perspective to know that there's people dealing with way worse things than Simon saying something nasty.
What happens to David Cook now? Do you get a record contract?
We're working out the kinks on a record deal, and I'm hopefully going to get into a recording studio here very quickly and start working on a record. Meanwhile, we've got this American Idol tour this summer. Starts July 1st in Glendale, and I think we go till September 13th in Tulsa.
Wow.
So I'm stoked. To be able to wake up in a different city every day is going to be really exciting.
Let me get an email question in, then we'll meet your compatriot in crime. This is from Carla in Puyallup, Washington. It's so apparent that you and Michael Johns are close friends, so inquiring minds would really love to know what he whispered in your ear Wednesday night as you finished singing Time of My Life.
Oh, wow. I honestly have no idea. You know, Mike is stand-up, you know?
He's a free spirit.
Yeah, I met him and Jason Yeager and Luke Menard day one of Hollywood Week, and we all just kind of bonded, and we started calling ourselves the Four Horsemen. And to have Mike there for that experience was really, really cool.
But you don't
But I was so lost that moment, I have no idea what he said.
And we'll take a break. When we come back, we'll meet the runner-up, David Archuleta, and then David will come back. They'll all be gathering. Getting ready to join us is David Archuleta, who gave Mr. Cook a run for his money. Archie is here right after the break.